So bone sarcomas are a rare collection of cancerous tumors that affect the bones predominantly, and they originate in the bones. The most common types are osteosarcoma, Ewing sarcoma, and chondrosarcoma. But there are multiple other subtypes as well. Each of them are rare. There's about 1,200 in the country every year. But at Johns Hopkins Hospital, we see a disproportionate number of those, and we have a very experienced team at managing them. Oftentimes, we can tell based off of imaging that there's an abnormality there that's highly concerning. But ultimately, we need a biopsy where our pathologist looks at a small piece of the tumor under a microscope to confirm that it really is a bone sarcoma. So it depends on the type of bone sarcoma. The most common being osteosarcoma or Ewing sarcoma are typically treated with a very coordinated course of chemotherapy and surgery. The surgery is a detailed surgery where we excise the entire tumor, though we specialize in limb salvage where we can save and reconstruct the limb and put them back together. We work closely with our colleagues from medical oncology or pediatric hematology and oncology to coordinate the timing of the chemotherapy versus the surgery to ensure optimal outcomes. So primary bone sarcomas can be found in any part of the body. The most common is in the femur. So osteosarcomas in particular tend to be around the knee, either in the lower part of the femur bone or the upper part of the tibia bone. Though frankly, they can occur in any part of the body, and we have a treatment option for each and every one of those spots. Typically, bone sarcomas present initially with pain, particularly pain that's at night, though they don't have to be painful all the time, and a mass. So oftentimes we note them because you have some discomfort in and around, say, the knee. On radiographs, we can start seeing that there's an enlarging or a swelling of the bone at that area that can be highly concerning for a sarcoma in many instances. Though others can be quite subtle, and it takes a good clinical acumen to be able to identify them. There are. Most bone sarcomas are sporadic, meaning that we don't know why they occurred, it just happened. Though there are some rare conditions, either patients that have had radiation for other causes, radiation is known to predispose to sarcomas, or there are some rare genetic conditions that can predispose to all sorts of cancers, including primary bone sarcomas. Though most of the time, we don't quite know the reason. So bone sarcomas can reoccur. They can occur either locally in the area where it was initially taken out, or it can recur systemically, meaning somewhere else in the body. We do very close surveillance, and obviously we take great care in our surgeries to ensure that we can minimize the risk of any local recurrence. Well, we're constantly exploring new ways to go and augment and improve the outcomes for our patients. That's both on the surgery side as well as the radiation and chemotherapy side of our treatment plans. We work closely with national and international cooperative groups as well in order to go and make sure that we are at the cutting edge for all of our treatment strategies.